Hello, this is Patriot in the Dark. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to check out the Revolver OWB holster from VersaCarry. Now this is an all-leather holster. It's universal and it's made in the USA. So let's check it out. Alright, so like I said, this is the Revolver OWB holster from VersaCarry. Their info is in the description below. But we'll get into this holster. Now it is an outside the waistband holster. It is all leather and it's water buffalo leather. All right, now this is two-toned. The back one-third of the holster is the distressed brown, which has a really nice, more natural feel to it. The front two-thirds is a black leather. So good guys wear black, so that's always impresses me. There is a seam across the center and they overlap. All right, the stitching feels really nice. I haven't found anything that sticks out or causes me any concern, and I always try to find something. It has a retention adjustment, basically just a Phillips, and there's a rubber grommet which ends up pulling it tighter. Now this is a universal holster. If you haven't checked out VersaCarry, if you go to their website, they have kind of a cool setup. Basically, you locate your firearm, whatever firearm you're looking for, a holster for, and it'll tell you the size to select your holster. All right, so you have, I believe, five different sizes. You have 1, 2, 3, a revolver, and then a new one, which is the P365. So once you find out the size, if it's a 1 or a 2, then when you get over to whatever holster you want, you can just select that. This is a right-handed holster. All right. Like I said, the feel of this, the leather feels really nice. It is softer than I'm used to. Now, VersaCarry did send me this, and I'm really glad they did, because up to this point, I've never really paid much attention to universal holsters, never had an interest in them. Now, this is my second one, and I've used it with both the Smith & Wesson 442 J frame, as well as the Ruger SP101, and we'll go into that right now. We'll check them out. All right, so this is the Smith & Wesson 442 J frame. Now, I haven't adjusted the tension on this, but like I said, you can, but we're going to go between both of these. So it fits in there nice. It covers up, obviously, your trigger's covered. The back side has a nice raise to it, so your cylinder release and is covered. All right, so that's not going to come in contact with you. All right, and even with, since I didn't even adjust this yet, you do have some pretty good retention, and I think the design features kind of follow the lines of the revolver. We'll try the Ruger now. All right, and this is the SP101 357 with the 2-inch barrel. All right, and so as you can see, that fits in there nice. It does cover up, the trigger is covered. Your trigger guard does stick out a little bit, but that's normal with the revolver. But the feels really good. Like I said, I try to find something that concerns me with them, and if there's any imperfections in the cuts, but I haven't been able to find anything. Now this one, it covers up everything as well. Seems really nice, and being that it's made in the U.S., I think it's a pretty good quality holster. I'd like to add, if you do find something at VersaCarry that you want, if you use the code PATRIOT at checkout, they'll give you a 15% off. Now, I don't get anything for it. It doesn't help me out any. It just helps you guys out for checking out these videos. So let's get back to the review. And one of the concerns I had originally, seeing that it had the two-tone, where it is, does have the seam on the front of the holster, it is overlapped. You can feel on the inside, the stitching is smooth. There's no lumps, there's no place for anything to catch on. The inside of the holster is more of an open nap, right? It's just a natural leather, right? The leading edge of your holster on the black leather, it seems a little stiffer. It has more of a buff polish feel to it. And it also has what they call vents, which are just some slits, more of a aesthetics, I think, across the leading edge. You know, there's a couple there. So it feels really nice, and I've been pretty happy with it. I've carried it most with the J-frame, but then I thought about, you know, checking this out. It does say that this one will actually work with your LCRs, but I don't have one here right now. So make sure you check them out, VersaCarry. Their info is in the description below. If you like this, give me a thumbs up there, and make it an outstanding day. Never fear the dark.